Hello and welcome to BibliLit. In this video, we are going to discuss We Are Seven, which is a folk ballad written by William Wordsworth. In this, there is a conversation between a person who signifies reasoning and reason and a young 8-year-old cottage girl. She signifies the sound of innocence and simplicity. It begins with the lines, "A simple child that lightly draws its breath and feels its life in every limb. What should it know of death?" This is a rhetorical question that the poet asks, and he says that the child is very simple. It's just breathing and feeling life in every limb, and the child is too simple, and the innocence of the child makes the child unaware of the idea of death. "I met a little cottage girl. She was 8 years old. She said, her hair was thick with many a curl that clustered round her head." So this person meets a cottage girl who's 8 years old, and he sees that her hair is very thick and curly and is clustered round her head. She had a rustic woodland air, and she was wildly clad. Her eyes were fair and very fair. Her beauty made me glad. So when the person meets the girl, he sees that she's very beautiful and she has that rustic sort of look in her, and he sees that she's very beautiful and it makes him very glad. He asks her, "Sister and brothers, little maid, how many may you be?" "How many?" "7 in all," she said, and wondering looked at me. So here we see there is a conversation going on between the person and the little cottage girl. And he's trying to ask, "How many brothers and sisters are you? How many siblings do you have?" She says she's got 7 brothers and sisters. Then he asks, "And where are they? I pray you tell." She answered, "7 are we, and 2 of us at Conway dwell, and 2 are gone to sea." 2 of her siblings are dead, and they are in the churchyard, and they are buried over there. But she lives near by the area, so she says that she dwells near them with her mother. So the stranger says, "You say that 2 at Conway dwell and 2 are gone to sea, yet ye are 7. I pray you tell, sweet maid, how this may be." So the person is trying to reason with the girl that you're telling 2 are at the sea and 2 are at the Conway dwell, then how are you 7? Like, 2 are already dead. That is what the person is trying to convey to the girl. Then did the little maid reply, "7 boys and girls are we. 2 of us in the churchyard lie, beneath the churchyard tree. You run about, my little maid, your limbs, they are alive. If 2 are in the churchyard laid, then ye are only 5. So the person is trying to tell to the little girl that if 2 of your siblings are dead, they are in the churchyard, so you are not 7. You are left as only 5. You are only 5 siblings now, since 2 of them have passed away. Their graves are green. They may be seen," the little maid replied, 12 steps or more from my mother's door, and they are side by side." She says, "But their grave is green. It signifies life. And they live near me," because the girl and her mother stay close by to the burial area. So she's telling that, you know, they are alive for me. "My stockings there I often knit, my kerchief there I hem, and there upon the ground I sit and sing a song to them." She's trying to convey that she still is involved with her siblings, those who have passed away. She sits with them and spends time with them, doing knitting and hemming and singing songs to them. "And often after sunset, sir, when it is light and fair, I take my little porringer and eat my supper there," she says. "Sometimes she often eats along, sitting beside their graves. The first that died was Sister Jane. In bed she mourning lay, till God released her of her pain, and then she went away." So first her sister Jane died, and she was buried. So in the churchyard she was laid, and when the grass was dry, together round her grave we played, my brother John and I. So her other sibling, that is her brother John, Both of them used to play near the grave of their sister Jane. And when the ground was white with snow and I could run and slide, my brother John was forced to go and he lies by her side. So she's trying to convey that soon after her sister died, Jane, then her brother also died, that was John, and he also was buried near the sister. Then the person says, "How many are you then?" said I. "If they too are in heaven," quick was the little maid's reply. "O master, we are seven." So the person says, "But they are dead, those two are dead, their spirits are in heaven." 'Twas throwing words away, for still the little maid would have her will and said, "Nay, we are seven." So in this poem, we see that the little maid or the little cottage girl is trying to continuously tell that though her two siblings have passed away, they are still seven. And she still feels that they are with them and all of them are together. Because though they are dead, she still gets time to be with them, and near the grave, she sits and tries to be connected with the two as well. So in this poem, we realize that there is a spirit of reasoning and a spirit of innocence. And here, Wordsworth talks about this particular idea and he conveys this thought in the poem.